kind of curious what you think accounts for the legacy of Kennedy. He's now seen as this heroic figure, a peacemaker, a rebel, and people on the left, like Jacobin and Counterpunch and Majority Report, have been giving a lot of airplay and a lot of ink to Stone's argument. How did Kennedy become such an icon for liberals, progressives, or even radicals based on what he actually did?
PR. It's very similar to what happened with Reagan. And I rather suspect that Reagan's propaganda agents used Kennedy as a model. Now, if you look back at Reagan, he was not a particularly popular president. If you look at polling, sort of normal. After his death, there was a huge propaganda campaign launched, Reagan Legacy, massive campaign, which turned him into a godlike figure. I mean, it reached the point where you could read a book by two scholars at the Hoover Institute at Stanford University years later, who said that whatever our troubles may be, it's not too bad because Ronald Reagan's spirit is hovering over us like a warm and friendly ghost. That's scholarly community. Well, that was achieved by enormous propaganda, denying, playing down his massive crimes and atrocities, which was pretty easy because the liberal intellectuals also played them down. And, you know, they're just mistakes and so on, nothing really terrible. Concocting this divine figure. Pretty much the same with Kennedy. You look at his actual record, it was awful. I mean, before the assassination, I can go through it, but he launched a major terrorist war against Cuba, terrorism, serious terrorism, out of hysteria after the Bay of Pigs. He turned down Khrushchev's offer for detente, reducing offensive military weapons, could have led to a much more peaceful world. Instead, he reacted by the biggest military buildup probably in peacetime history, though the US was way ahead. Now, those were the two factors that led Khrushchev to put missiles in Cuba, almost led to the destruction of the world. In Latin America, he, 1962, he shifted the mission of the Latin American military, which of course the US can control, shifted it from hemispheric defense, which was an anachronism from the Second World War, to internal security. Internal security in the Latin American context means, well, I won't use my words, I'll use the words of his leading specialist in counterinsurgency, head of counterinsurgency under Kennedy and Johnson, Charles Machling. He said this signaled a change from tolerance for the rapacity and brutality of the Latin American military to direct participation by the United States in crimes that you could trace back to Goebbels and Himmler. Well, that's the head of counterinsurgency under Kennedy. And he's correct if you look at what happened. Kennedy actually sent a special forces mission to Colombia, which was the scene of the worst atrocities. And they recommended paramilitary terror against known communist adherents, which means priests organizing peasants, human rights workers, and so on, led to a huge increase in atrocities. In Vietnam, when Kennedy came in, it was bad enough. The Eisenhower administration had been supporting a terrorist regime which had already killed maybe 50, 60,000 people, beginning to elicit resistance. Kennedy sharply escalated the war, 1961 and 62, authorized napalm, authorized crop destruction, began sending US Air Force planes under South Vietnamese markings to carry out bombing programs to drive peasants who the US intelligence knew were supporting the National Liberation Front, to drive them into what amounted to concentration camps, strategic hamlets, where they could be so-called protected from the guerrillas that they were supporting, a massive escalation of the war. In fact, if you look around the total record, it's pretty awful. Then came the assassination. Actually, even before the assassination, the propaganda was strong enough so that he, public opinion polls regarded him as one of the great American presidents. So even before the, then after the assassination came something that was later duplicated in the Reagan legacy propaganda. And we're now seeing right in front of us with the adoration of Trump. Once you start adoring a political figure, all reason disappears. It goes into madness. We've seen plenty of examples of that in history.